Hello and welcome to another video. Today's topic is custom connections. As the name suggests, these are completely user-defined connections where a number of edits become a matter of a few clicks, as you can see in the examples shown in the background. Custom connections can be very simple or very complex. There are no limits to your creativity. For example, two or any number of profiles can be combined with add-on parts and machining. In order to be able to use your own custom connections, they must be created and saved once. We will now see how this is done. This is our starting point. The smaller stage beam will be connected to the larger beam with a double clip angle connection. First, we will use the Cope Cut tool and select the beam we want to cut, and then the beam we want to connect. SolidSteel has remembered the parameters from the last use, and this is also appropriate here. Of course, we can now set the shape of the cut, the size, etc. as we need. A click on Execute and the Cope Cut, performed at part level, is finished. Now we continue with the double clip angle connection by starting the angular connection function and defining that we want to connect this face to this face. We immediately get a preview of the joint, and SolidSteel also suggests the last used connection, in this case the IW2021. This fits well, we can confirm immediately, and the joint is inserted. Of course, all useful parameters can be adjusted by the user here too. You can also see the second clip angle in this view. The only thing missing is a rib, which we can now add using the function of the same name. We select this beam and can already see the preview of the rib on the right. As a reference for placement, let's select this edge here at the front. I'm going to zoom in a bit so you can see better that the rib is now centered on the reference edge. This is still not perfectly aligned with the web of the beam. An additional offset of -2 mm will correct this. Good. But of course, we only want to create the rib on one side, and in this case on the other side of the profile. Confirm, and the rib is inserted. This was quick, but since we usually use such joints several times per assembly, the time required would add up. That's why we now create a custom connection from these three separate steps and can save a lot of time in the future. To do this, we start the Learn Custom Connection function, select the cross beam and end beam, and all the connections that are present on either of the selected beams are now listed here. The checkboxes are then used to select the clip angle connections, machining operations such as our Cope Cut, and of course, the rib. I can tell that this is the right rib because the reference edge is highlighted. I stopped the video for a moment because when I placed the rib a minute ago, I didn't mention why it was aligned to a component edge and not a sketch line. The reason is simple. You want your custom connections to be as flexible as possible. And in this example, I know that the rib should always be placed exactly centered on the web of the stage beam on the opposite side of the larger beam. Placing it using a component reference is therefore more logical and flexible than using a sketch line. Okay, let's continue. The rib is now also selected with the checkbox. We give the custom connection a name and click on Execute to save the connection. From now on, we can use it anytime the installation situation is suitable. Let's test it immediately on the opposite side. To do this, we switch to the custom connection function. Now we define that we want to connect the stage beam to this beam. The connection we just saved is displayed. We select it, immediately get a preview, and with a single click to confirm, the complete connection is inserted. This saves time and is just one of the many functions of SolidSteel Parametric for Autodesk Inventor. Try it out for yourself and download the free express version today. You can find all the information you need on our website. And of course, we would also be very pleased if you liked the video and subscribe. See you next time.